if this time-space reality has caused you to focus a desire into being, it can be what you want to call a see it, hear it, smell it, taste it, touch it reality. In other words, it doesn't just have to be a dream that you feel good about. It can be a reality that you sleep with or park in your garage. In other words, we want desires to be born, but we want you to be all right with the desire that hasn't manifested fully, because we want you to be satisfied with the early manifestations of your desires. And what are the earliest signs of manifestations? More ideas coming. The contrast, of course, is the earliest of all. The contrast is what gives birth to it. But once you've given birth to it, you've got to begin to line up with it. Otherwise, you can't realize it. You won't recognize it. You can't sniff it out. You can't be on the trail of it. You can't want it and doubt it and be moving toward it. When you want it and doubt it, you're moving away from it. When you want it and feel nervous about it, you're not allowing yourself to be in the receptive mode of realizing it. And the reason that that word realize is such a good word is because your path is being revealed to you all the time. In other words, the source within you knows what you've asked for and knows where you stand in relationship to what you've asked for, and is giving you continual guidance about how to close that gap between the wanting it and the full realization of it. You have come into these physical bodies because you expected full realization of ideas. That's why it is a time and space reality. That's why you have these physical senses to translate the realism into its fullest form. So when a vibration is translated by you, the first thing that happens is you'll have a thought about it, and in the moment that the thought comes, you'll have an emotional manifestation, which is the indicator of how on pitch you are vibrationally with your desire. Now, your desires you launched incrementally. You moved through life, have been for quite a while. You even had launched desires about your future life experience even before you came into this physical body. So there was a well-imagined path already in place that you intended to come into this body, integrate with others, and realize fully through all of your physical senses. So when you got here, your physical senses were working so well, you didn't even realize that you were an expert vibrational translator. You just thought that you were seeing and hearing and smelling and tasting and touching. You didn't realize that you were translating vibration into a reality. And because most don't realize that you are vibrational, then most try to control the environment through action, through behavior, mostly through controlling others to get others to conform to your idea of what you want. But it's really a rare person who really gets it, that you are a vibrational being who has the ability to control your vibrational output through focus. And that when you control your vibrational output, you also control what comes into you in terms of a realized life. Because the law of attraction says that whatever you are vibrationally emitting is what is coming back to you. Because in your emanation, you set a vibration that equals your receiving. Now, we have not said that to you before. Do you know that you set your receptive mode by your transmission mode? What you focus on is how you focus your dial. So you can't be saying one thing and getting another. You can't be thinking one thing and getting another. You can't be feeling one thing and getting another. The universe does not hear your words. The universe is responding to your vibrational output. So, as you are offering this signal based upon what you are giving your attention to, whether it is in the past as you are remembering it, or in the present as you are observing it, or in the future as you may be imagining it. It doesn't matter. You're doing it right now. It's causing you to emit a signal now. That signal equals your point of attraction now, and the whole universe is queued up to respond to that vibration. Now, the reason that we want to talk to you about vibration is not because we want you to be guarded about it right here, right now. In the beginning of you listening to us, so often you would realize that you do create your own reality, and first you would say, oh good, and then you would say, oh no, because you realized you did not really have steady control of what you were emitting. And then some of you, as we said, you create your own reality, began going cancel, trying to suck things back before the universe got hold of them and delivered them to you in full manifested form. But now you are beginning to realize that you have leeway, that yes, you're offering vibration about wanted and unwanted, but you stand in a stable place. And so mostly what we want you to take away from this conversation is that you can be more practiced than most of you are being. And the thing that would help you to emit the vibration, the one you want to emit, meaning the one that you want to be answered, the easiest way to do that is by caring, really caring about how you feel. Because when you care about how you feel, you're alert to your emotions. You're alert to your emotions, which are your guidance system. Your guidance system, which is giving you constant in-the-moment feedback between what you've asked for. Another way of saying that is all that you have already vibrationally become, and what you're allowing yourself to realize in its full manifested form. That is as clear as we've ever said it. In other words, you want to be aware of that gap, and you don't need to think about closing it tightly all the time, because you can't. Life is causing you to expand continually. You're never going to completely close that gap. So here's how it works. You sift through life. You know what you don't want, which causes you to know what you do want. You emit a signal about it, and vibrationally speaking, you become an integrated being with that new desire that you have discovered. Vibrationally speaking, you become it. We're going to stand over here in the vibrational spot, in what we call the vortex or the vibrational reality. You have become this newly improved version. Life caused you to become it. Oh, you haven't manifested it yet, most likely. It's a new idea to you. It's a new idea that isn't all that familiar. It's a new and improved idea. But the larger part of you, the non-physical part of you that existed before you came into this body, that still exists in the non-physical realm, even though you're here in this body, that part of you became that newly improved, that newly expanded vibrational version that life just caused you to become. But you're probably still standing over here in the same beliefs. Belief's just a thought you keep thinking. It's a habit of thought. Standing over here in the same beliefs that you held when you launched that rocket. You're not ready to believe in your ultimate prosperity. Life caused you to want more money, but you don't believe in the more money that life just caused you to ask for. If you believed in it, it would be flowing into your experience. So we began talking about this vibrational reality, and we called it your vortex. We wrote a whole book about it, wanting you to realize, wanting you to accept that there is a vibrational version of you that you may or may not, usually not completely, be up to speed with. And that vibrational version of you is calling you toward it. It's calling because law of attraction is focused upon that new and improved version of you. And law of attraction is summoning all cooperative components to it. The question is, are you a cooperative component to your own desire? And the answer to that, in many cases, is no, not yet. I do not believe this thing I want. I'm giving lip service to it. Life keeps showing me that I want it, but I am, we're speaking from your perspective, often so wrapped up in the observation of what is, because after all, I can see what is, I can hear what is, I can smell it and taste it and touch it. What is so vivid. What is so vivid. Most of my vibration is about what is. And we want to say to you, That's a bit of a problem. Because if what is so vivid, you give your attention only to what is can't change much. You've got to let go of what is a bit. You've got to stop telling it like it is and begin telling it as you want it to be. You've got to lighten up. You've got to stop defending what is as if there is someone standing there saying, "Why is that?" All right, your mother did do that to you. How'd you get there? What are you doing there? What are you doing? What are you doing? Why did you do that? Why aren't you further down the road? You've heard those questions. And you've developed a pattern of answering them that comes out in your personality, like defending yourself, or like justifying yourself, or like rationalizing. And we want you to cut that out, because every minute you spend in defense is a moment in resistance, not in allowing. It's in resistance, not in receiving. It's in resistance to the path that is calling you, and that's why you feel negative emotion. So some things you want to know. First, if the path were not calling you, you would never feel resistance. Next, if you hadn't asked for stuff, the path wouldn't be calling you. So if you weren't mixing it up and expanding, then there wouldn't be an improved version of you calling you forward. But since there is, and since you can't change that, since you are eternal beings, since there is a source within you, since there is a source within you who knows all that you have become, who is calling you and other cooperative components to these focused points of realization. Ah, you rendezvousing with the things along your path, that's what life really is. You see, it's not just the final destination that you're rendezvousing with. You're rendezvousing with all the fun along the way. You get to rendezvous with the new idea. You get to rendezvous with the new and improved version. You get to rendezvous with the others who are ready to play with you. That's what you signed up for. That's what you wanted. That's what you said you are about. You are deliberate creators, genius creators, here in the best environment ever, launching rockets of desire all day, every day, and often holding yourself back from what you have expanded to be.